Now, WGEM Sports with Garrett Tiaz.
It was Championship Sunday in the golf world. It was day two and the final day of the City Championship at Westview Golf Course. Ryan Shankey and Alex McCullough were tied for the lead to start Sunday. They were paired with the two guys that were one stroke behind them, Adam Pfeiffer and Blaze Haxel, and the four kept it close today. Alex McCullough would bogey his first two holes of the day, but on hole 13, he puts it right by the hole. I mean, what a chip. And McCullough taps it in. He gets the birdie to go, and he is two strokes behind the leader. Adam Pfeiffer was the two-stroke leader at the time, as we are still on hole 13, and Ryan Schwenke with the birdie putt opportunity here. And I mean, look at the ball roll and right to the bottom of the hole. What touch by Schwenke, and he is now one stroke behind the leader. Hole 14 now, and Schwenke has the short birdie putt, the tie for the lead, but he leaves it short and to the right of the hole. He would par it and remain one stroke behind. On to hole 17, the leader, Adam Pfeiffer, back with a two-stroke lead and is looking for the eagle putt. He has the right line. Will it go? No. Just a bit shy of the hole. He taps it in for birdie, giving him a three-stroke lead over McCullough and Schwenke. Going into hole 18, and on hole 18, Pfeiffer, his second shot, he puts it beautifully on the green, setting up a two-putt for par, and he would use it perfectly. Pfeiffer taps it in. He finished the tournament 6 under par, shooting back-to-back 68s, and he is your champion. This is Pfeiffer's 8th championship. He now ties the record for the most. He spoke about his mindset going into the day, which one stroke behind the leader.
Well, luckily, I've been able to do well in this tournament and win it from behind, having the lead, so I really felt like I was in a good position. You can't win it the first day, but you certainly can lose it. So I put myself in a good position. I didn't feel uncomfortable by being one stroke behind, because it's just a one-hole swing. Birdie here, bogey there, and you're right there. And even being two down with the back nine starting, I still felt confident where I was at.
On the women's side, Crystal Bergtorf started the final day with the lead, and that's where she would end after day two, as Bergtorf shoots a 72 to secure the win. The William Woods Jr. and former QHS Blue Devil wins by 10 strokes over the 2 days. The WGM Sports Cam caught up with the winner, who talked about playing with a lead.
I just try to think about the shot that I'm hitting right then and there, and I don't really think about what happened yesterday or what could happen in the future holes, because when I get my mind going like that, I just overthink everything. So trying to keep myself level-headed and just doing what I could.
Congrats to the winners.